It is a gloomy yet beautiful day here in Los Angeles. And I guess this is the first official vlog of 2019. There's a huge chopper behind me because there's like a protest, so it might be a little loud. Basically, what I want to do with the vlogs is I want to show you guys more of my life like I did back in 2006 and 2017. 2018, I kind of went away from daily vlogging, and I'm not going to bring back daily vlogging, but I'm going to be vlogging a lot more of my life because there is going to be some huge changes this year. So this is the start. This is the first new episode of the new series of 2019. So let's get things started. And what we're doing for today, it's too loud here, all right? So I'm gonna explain what we're doing today in the car. So let's get out of here. Stigmata. So we just pulled up to the outlets. Now, this is my first time in a long time coming to an outlet mall in LA. Usually I go in other cities, but like in LA, outlet malls aren't really common. You gotta go like on the outskirts. So basically, we drove past downtown and we're here at this outlet. Hold on, this guy's looking at me, so it's gonna be weird. See? I wanted to make a Nike outlet video because I personally love Nike outlet videos. I like watching them because it's interesting to see what you can find in certain places at certain prices. The thing about outlets compared to like retail stores is like you go into a Nike store and most of the time every Nike store is going to have the same products at the basic product. When you go to an outlet, there might be one or two shoes that you would not expect to be there. That's what I kind of want to see. But the thing is, I didn't want to just make this an outlet shopping video. I kind of wanted to make it like a life hack slash things they don't want you to know about outlets. Basically, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell you guys things that maybe the average consumer doesn't know. Maybe some of you guys know, but maybe the average person who's going into a Nike outlet doesn't know. Basically, we're gonna go in there, we're gonna look what they got. I'll give you guys some tips and all that stuff because I used to actually work at a Nike store. I used to work at a clearance store. The first thing I gotta tell you, which is tip number one, show up early. I remember when I used to work at Nike, whenever we'd get some dope products, we'd put them out in the beginning of the day. You have a fresh stock of everything because they do replenish the floor the night before. So go early and not worry about missing out on anything. Go in the beginning of the day. That's the hack tip number one. Let's go inside and see what other steals and deals we can find. Now, once we got into the store, the audio was so bad because the music was so loud, so that's why I'm doing this voiceover. As I was shopping through the store, instead of finding hacks and tips of how to get steals, I noticed that everything was pretty much retail that was good. Like, all the shoes that I found were literally retail price. What is the point of a clearance store if all the good stuff is retail price? Now, I know there's like your running shoes and your basketball shoes that you'll be able to get on discount, but most of the retro Jordans and just dope stuff, even like jerseys and stuff, were just regular price. I didn't understand why. When I used to work there, every single product that would come into the store, whether it was a new release or an old release, was discounted. I guess things aren't the same anymore. And I know what you see in me. You see the truth, see the me in me. You see enough to believe in me. You see your son, but is he in me? Yo, so we're back at the crib now, and you know what they say, new year, new me. New year, new collection. I'm not a sneakerhead, I'm not a collector that, you know, stacks up and has hundreds and hundreds of shoes. Like, there are collectors like that, but I've always been the type to where I like to rotate my collection a lot. I like to get rid of things that I stop wearing, and I like to get new things. Being a YouTuber and like on social media, mainly for sneakers and fashion, like you always have to have what's new, what's coming out. And what I do every once in a while is I clean out the collection and I get rid of some shoes. I'll give away some shoes, I'll sell some shoes. Basically, there's a few shoes that I've given away that I haven't really shown on camera to like friends and family. There is a few shoes that I'm gonna be giving away to
to you guys, but I'm gonna save that for another video. Today we're gonna be talking about some of the shoes that I'm gonna be selling, and they're right here in front of me. So as you can see right here, we've got a ton of shoes and we've got a ton of heat. So basically, I'm gonna show you guys everything I'm selling and how much I'm selling it for and where I'm selling it. If you guys know, I sell on one place, and that is the SneakerCon app. The SneakerCon app is a place where you can buy and sell sneakers. They authenticate the shoe for you so that you know you're buying something 100% legit if you're a buyer. Basically, SneakerCon is the middleman of the deal, of the selling of the sneakers. They're not gonna be like steals, they're just gonna be good deals because most of these are worn. Most of them don't have boxes. I think only two of them have boxes, but these are lower than market price on all of them. Yeah, I'm gonna quickly get into it. I don't want to take too much time talking about this, so I'm gonna try to go through this quick. So the first shoe is this one right here. Now, I listed this a few months ago and I promoted it and they did not sell because it's an expensive shoe. This is a size 7. Originally we had them up for $1,000, so now we have listed these for $820. Another shoe, Flyknit Jordan 3s, we're gonna list these for $80. These are $80 used. And by the way, if something's listed, for example, like those Flyknit Jordan 3s are listed for $80. If somebody shoots me an offer, say they offer like $70, I might take it. I can accept offers on the app. Obviously, if somebody offers me like $20, I'm not gonna take it. But if somebody gives me a reasonable offer, I might think about it and I might accept it depending on how I'm feeling. So I actually ended up getting two pairs of these. One of them I already got from the SneakerCon app, so this one has already been authenticated. Used once, I'm selling these for $165. Pharrell Human Race, this is the BBC colorway, another one that's already authenticated right there. You see the tag. These ones are dead stock, size 10, and I'm selling these under retail for $200. The Blazers, I'm selling my pair. It wasn't my style. Size 10, used, we're selling these for $435. LeBron, what does? This is the LeBron 16. They literally look like they're dead stock. We're gonna be selling these for $250. Satin Jordan 1s, this was a hard one for me. I didn't think I would be able to sell this. I had to let these go, man. I just don't wear them, and they are a 10.5. These I'm gonna be selling for $750. Now, originally, dead stock, they go for over $1,000, but I'm gonna be selling them for $750. Cause 4s, this shoe right here. This was probably the biggest L I've taken. I bought this shoe when nobody knew it was coming out. Everyone thought it was friends and family. I got offered this one, and I bought it because I was wrapping my car with the Cause wrap, if you guys remember. And I was like, oh, this would be the perfect shoe to be wearing when I go pick up my car. It was like the perfect idea for me. I paid $4,000 for this shoe. $4,000. If I could go back in time, I would slap the out of myself for that. Like, that was the stupidest decision. And then they ended up coming out and the price went from 4,000. Now these sell for less than $1,000, and guess how much I'm selling it for. Size 10.5. That's another thing, I'm a 10. These are a 10.5, so they're a little big. I'm selling these for $550. So if you want to own a shoe that I paid $4,000 for only $550, they are going to be available on the SneakerCon app. This is the one shoe that I hope sells the quickest.
Is the quality like different though from like the original pair?
It's the original pair is great.
I mean, the people that the one that released.
It's the same thing. So the rumor is, which I'm not allowed to say who told me this, but the black pair wasn't supposed to be made. It was made by Jordan Brand without the permission of Cause. And when Cause found out, they got upset and they said, the pairs you made, we're gonna sell it on our website. So it only came out on the Cause website. That's what I heard. It's a rumor. I don't know. That's what I heard. But next up, these ones. These ones might go quick because I know a lot of people want these. These go for like $1,000. This is a size 10.5, a little too big for me. I'm selling these for $600. I only wore them once, really good condition. Only the bottom is dirty. Another shoe that was hard for me to get rid of, but it's like, I don't wear these anymore. The Lance Mountain SB Jordan 1s. Obviously all the paint is removed, but I wore the hell out of these in pretty good condition as far as like wear and tear. Like, they're still like really, really good. So I'm only gonna sell these for $100, size 10. OVOs, I'm selling both of my OVO Jordan 8s. I just don't wear them at all. Like, I've worn the black pair, the white pair I haven't wore, and it's just one of those shoes where I want to own it, but I don't need it right now. Like I said, the black pair I have worn once. I'm selling the black pair for $200.
Isn't that under retail?
That is under retail. The white pair I'm selling for retail. So if anybody wants these for retail, $225. Jordan 11, capped gowns, never worn, size 10. I'm selling these these for $200. That's under retail. I think retail was $250. Double Tap Vans. So these ones are a little bit tricky. These are a pair of Vans. It was a collaboration with some company that I honestly don't even know. Or it's called W Taps. I don't know what they're dope. Like Vans with flames on them. What I did was I bought both pairs and I put them together and I wore them like this. And then obviously I have an extra pair of mismatching pairs, so I'm selling the pair. So yeah, if anybody wants to buy the mismatch pair, you get one of each and you get one right shoe, one left shoe. So it is wearable, but I'm only selling these for $100. I think I listed it on the orange pair. So if you're looking for these, look on the orange pair, Hyperdunks, Off-White Hyperdunks. I actually had two pairs. So this is the dead stock pair. This is a 10.5. I think the laces are missing, but obviously they still have the original lace. Or it has one black lace, one white lace, and I'm gonna be selling these for $500. Mocha 3s. I don't know why I bought two pairs of these.
So I'm at the outlet today.
Yeah, we did just see these at the outlets. I'm selling them for cheaper than they have them at the outlets. At the outlets, these were what, $225, right?
Retail.
No, they were $190 at the outlets. So these were $190 at the outlets. I'm selling these dead stock, size 10, for $150. Last but not least, we got the Day of the Dead Kyries. I don't know why I bought these, but I bought them, and then I was kind of like, why did I buy these? I regret buying these.
I didn't even see you buy
them. I like them. They're inspired by the Day of the Dead Dunks. I bought them, and then I'm like, yo, like, this is like, I can't wear this. $80 under retail. So that's it. So those are all the shoes I'm selling. Like I said, they're all going to be available on the SneakerCon app. So yeah, man, that pretty much wraps up the activities for today's video. Currently three.
The seven.
Yeah, you're right. I should talk about that. So basically on January 26th of this month, obviously because it's January, we are having the biggest pop-up in the history of mankind. Like, bruh, this is insane. So in Phoenix, Arizona, we are having a pop-up with me, Yeezy Busta, Blazendary, Ari Petru, Jacob Starr, Harrison Neville, Tony D, Too Wild. It starts at 10 a.m. It's at a store called Guest List at the mall. Forgot what the mall name is, but the store is called Guest List. I'm gonna have the address right here. But basically from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., we are gonna be having a pop-up. We are gonna have exclusive merch for sale. Like one item that represents all of us. That's gonna be for sale and give away some sneakers as well. We're gonna be doing some sneaker giveaways for free. So yeah, Phoenix, make sure you guys come out, or if you're just anywhere in Arizona, even if you got a couple hour drive, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got your gas money, but I'm sure you'll have a good time to make up for the gas money or something like that. But anyway, yeah, come through. It's gonna be absolutely insane. I think that's pretty much gonna be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm gonna spend the rest of the day probably cleaning all these shoes back up and hopefully packing them to send to you guys. And yeah, we're pretty much done, so.
As I travel this road of light, with the road in light, where the slang is engraved with a slave language, in the streets of babe, with the pain of slave ships, still I submit to it, falling stiff to it. How can I never get a fit to it? I see heaven at the end, I'm trying to get to it. Scared to get lost, and I admit to it, so I stick to it. This routine, me and my constituents.